Good morning, everyone. Welcome to the Finance Magnates Africa Summit 2024. Before we dive in, a quick reminder, online trading involves the risk of losing your funds. Make sure you understand all the risks involved, exercise caution, and trade with brokers you trust that hold the appropriate license by the FSCA. Now, without further ado, let's kick off the speaker sessions with our first workshop of the day, FX and CFDs in Africa, Key Industry Trends. Please give a warm welcome to Christoforos, Africa Regional Manager at Fxview.
Thank you, Jess.
Good morning, everybody. Thank you, Jeff, for the introduction. I'm very happy and very honored to be here. I would like to thank the organizer, FMs, for the opportunity to be a speaker at this exceptional event, which is, as we can see, very well organized. So let me start. We have 20 minutes. I will try to be, you know, as quick as possible. My name is Christoforos Panagiotou. I have 11 years experience in the Forex CFD industry. The last seven and a half years, I'm acting as Africa Regional Manager. My responsibilities are mainly the operational part, the development of our company, Fxview, in the Africa region, and mainly South Africa, Nigeria, Ghana, Tanzania, Kenya, and a number of other countries. I have the pleasure to travel very often to this amazing country, meeting a lot of people, and it's always a pleasure, but this time is an exceptional case, and once again, I would like to thank the organizers for the opportunity to be a speaker at this session. So today, I will be speaking about the FX and CFDs in Africa, key industry trends. Now, throughout my career, the last 11 years, I have gone through all the changes and the adjustments and the new trends in the Africa region related to the Forex CFD trading. And I'm very glad to say that we have seen great changes, positive changes, but still we have to do a lot, to go through a lot in order, you know, to make sure that this industry provides a safe environment for the traders. Because, as we always say, trading is risky. So we need to create the right framework, the right environment for the traders, so to make sure that everybody is trading using those conditions that will allow him or her to be either potentially profitable and at the same time to minimize the risk. We will see how Africa has joined the global financial markets, and the unique economy of Africa has fueled Forex and CFD trading innovation. We will see that by discovering the growth drivers, which is technological advancements, regulations, increased financial education for the traders. To see how those factors have enhanced trading accessibility, transparency, financial inclusion, and opening new investment opportunities. Now, we can definitely say the last few years that Africa is part of the global financial markets. This is a great development because 10, 15, 20 years ago, things were much different. Not only in Africa, but in other regions as well. But since we're discussing about Africa, we can say now that Africa has joined the global financial markets. Africa's integration into the global financial markets has had a significant impact on the growth and innovation of FX and CFDs trading in several ways. The first one is the increased market participation. as Africa economies have become more interconnected with the rest of the world, there has been a notable increase in market participation from Africa traders and investors in the FX and CFD markets. The availability of online trading platforms, mobile apps, and internet connectivity has made it easier for individuals across Africa to have access to the markets and participate in trading activities. Then we can see the diversification of investment portfolios. Integration into global financial markets has provided African investors with access to a wider range of investment opportunities beyond the traditional asset classes. FX and CFD trading allow investors to diversify their portfolios by trading various instruments such as currency pairs, commodities, indices, crypto, and this can help to reduce the risk and potentially increases profits. But I always emphasize the risk. For me, this is the most important aspect of the industry, because you can trade, you can have positive trades, but the most important thing is to be consistent. It doesn't matter how much positive is your trade, but it has to have consistency, and at the same time, it has to you have to apply the risk management. Then we have technology, which has helped a lot. And in my opinion, technology most probably is the most important aspect and the most important factor that has helped into that direction. The adoption of advanced technologies such as algorithmic trading systems, AI, artificial intelligence, machine learning has fueled innovation in the trading industry across Africa. We see the last few years, technology has given the opportunity to more and more traders, especially young traders, to enter the markets. Technology-driven trading platforms offer sophisticated tools and features that empower traders to analyze market data, execute trades, and manage risk more effectively, leading to increased efficiency and potential profitability. Again, technology and what we have mentioned here, again, helps in applying the correct risk management. Technology helps a lot when you analyze data, because analyzing data is a very important part of the trading activity, and this will help the traders to identify opportunities, but at the same time to identify the risk, the danger as well. Because when we enter a trade, when we enter the markets, we always think the both directions. Now, regulatory reforms and investor protection. This is again very, very important. The fact that the African market is integrated into global financial markets has prompted regulatory authorities in some African countries to enhance regulatory frameworks governing FX and CFD trading. The most important example is the South Africa FSCA regulation. Still though, there are several other countries that are moving to that direction and need to create an FX and CFD regulatory frame. These regulatory reforms aimed at protecting investors, ensuring market integrity, and promoting transparency. This has contributed to the growth of the industry by creating trust and confidence among traders. So, how this is related to the brokers? It is highly related, because from the moment there is regulatory frame, regulatory body within the market, within the country, such as South Africa, then the trader has the opportunity and the option to choose the broker to use for his or her trading activity. So it is highly recommended when we decide to enter the markets, which broker to use for our trading activity, if has the actual regulations, either the FSCA or any other under any other regulatory body. Education, another important factor that helps the growth of the industry. The integration into global markets has created a unique understanding of the importance of financial education and awareness among Africa traders and investors. We see several academies, educators, mentors, websites, blogs, forums offering education of financial markets on FX and CFD trading. So more and more people, again, especially young people, young traders, they are looking to have and receive education. Education for me is very, very important because, again, through education, you can learn about all the aspects of the industry, not only about fundamental or technical in trading strategies, if you're a day trader, if you do hedging, scalping, whatever, education will help you to understand the market, the opportunities, but again, at the same time, the risk involved. So when you educate yourself, when you are looking for a blog, a website, or someone to provide education to you, it is very, very important when you analyze which one you're going to choose for your education to see that they actually provide education on the risk as well. This is very, very important. Educational programs have been launched by different sources to provide individuals with the necessary knowledge and skills to navigate the complexities of FX and CFD trading. This resulted in creating a more informed and responsible trading community. Brokers have also contributed to this direction by offering free educational programs, seminars, webinars, and emphasizing on the risk of trading. So as we can see, and this is something that we are very happy to say, the brokers as well are offering those educational programs for free, either physical seminars, either webinars, workshops, forums, especially on the websites. We have one blogs, tutorials, videos, and everything. And very, very often, all the brokers are offering, let's say, this kind of webinars for different products, let's say instruments, trading strategies, but we give emphasis also on providing education on risk management as well. So the conclusion is that we see that Africa's integration into financial markets has catalyzed the growth and innovation of FX and CFD trading by expanding market participation, diversification of investment opportunities, embracing technology-driven solutions, implementing regulatory reforms, and promoting financial education and awareness. These developments have position Africa as an emerging and dynamic market for FX and CFD trading with several opportunities for growth and development in the years to come. So we can definitely say that Africa is playing a very, very important role in the financial markets, especially in the CFD and CFD and FX industry. We can surely say that in the whole, let's say, percentage of the global trading activity, Africa contributes a significant amount of trading volume. And we can proudly say that we are among the top 3-5 regions that provide, contribute this trading volume. At the same time, I can proudly say again that young traders in Africa, they are evolving, they are developing themselves in the industry, they are getting more knowledge, they are becoming more experienced, and they are looking to get education. This is very, very important, and I'm very happy to see this trend. Because, as I said, I started my career 11 years ago, and 9 years ago, I started evolving and getting more involved in the Africa region. At that time, I saw a lot of traders, especially the beginners, entering the market immediately. And they were not taking the time to search, first of all, about regulatory frames, about the broker, if it's regulated. They didn't take the time to check what is the risk involved. The only thing that they were taking into consideration, it was other people telling them how much profits they made. But those people, they never told them about the losses they had. This can happen today as well. It's happening. But I can say that nowadays, traders, they are more clever. I'm not saying that at that time people were not clever, but I can say they are more clever in terms of searching around. So you need to search. Social media is something that I didn't mention on the presentation, but social media has impacted a lot the industry, and especially, again, young traders who are using social media a lot. A few years ago, a lot of people were posting some fake photos with a Ferrari, with a helicopter, with a, I don't know, a yacht. Some of them were posting about owning an island near Seychelles. So this cannot happen now. You cannot fool people around. And I'm very happy to see that. So every one of us has the opportunity of the, and the option, of course, and the accessibility to internet, technology, and of course, the access to the brokers, to us, who are representing the brokers, so we can, you know, discuss, offer our opinion in terms of the market, but not a trading advice. So whatever we offer, it's, let's say, the trend in the market, but never, never we offer a trading advice. So to close this, I want to say that I'm very, very happy and very proud and very honored that I have been working in the African market for the last how many years. I have met amazing people. I have made friends that we have been, you know, evolving together, because myself, I evolve every day. I learn every day something new. But what I always keep in mind is to be transparent. We are transparent with our clients, with our traders, in terms of the conditions we offer. But at the same time, we are transparent in terms of the dangers, the risk, and everything when you enter the market. And my last advice is, when you start trading, take small steps. Never, never invest an amount that you are not comfortable to lose. This is a very important rule. For me, it's a rule. Never get, you know, excited, control your emotions. But again, at the same time, I see on social media every day a lot of people who call themselves gurus or mentors or whatever, and the only thing they teach is about control your emotions. I know how to control my emotions. Give me something better. So what I advise you guys, control your emotions, of course, but at the same time, control your trading, control the investment you have, the capital you have, and how much you risk per trade. And when something goes wrong, stop what you are doing, take a break, go back and check what went wrong, what trades you took, what time you took the trades, what instruments you traded, what lot size you used, all these kind of things, so you can understand or partially understand what went wrong, so adjust your strategy. Thank you so much. I'm very honored for your participation here. It is a privilege. Thank you so much. Enjoy the expo, all the rest, and you can see me at booth 11. Thank you very much.